Did you see that Firefox sign at the Chicago game?
Yeah, the Firefox guys have, like, endorsed it.
Dude, someone on my Instagram, like, on their thing, showed their friend holding the sign. I'm like, you know that guy?
Yeah, Firefox, one of, like, the higher-ups at Firefox actually came out dropping all kinds of fucking bear lingo. And they hit him with the Bears, hit him with a Super Bowl shuffle jam. There's like five or six like bear plugs in the two paragraph article he wrote. But if he says, if you want to get down and you want to hold up a Firefox logo at a game, to tweet at Firefox, and they will mail you a fucking logo for you to hold up at the game. I mean, this is the freest marketing there ever was.
It's incredible. It's genius. It's
genius. Super marketing. I mean, you got to embrace this kind of shit. They said they are holding up an outdated Firefox logo. They were holding up an outdated logo. They want to get their ass refreshed with the new logo, baby.
Who even uses Firefox?
I don't know. I've been on the Chrome for...
I love Chrome. For whatever. That's what I used to. Yeah.
I mean, my God, though, Bears. I mean, we're talking about Firefox logo is like probably the brightest thing going on in Chicago, considering the Bears right now. I'm looking at 3-8 Bears. I mean, John Fox talking about this is a performance-driven league. Well, fucking John, you're 12-31 as a Bears fucking head coach. So we're talking about performance. So you're basically saying that I deserve to be fired. And I mean, my fucking goodness.
At this point, he might want to be fired.
I mean, we always take these fucking... We need to stop drafting so many high-ceiling, low-floor fucking players. Like Kevin Way, I mean, this guy clearly needs to drink more milk. He needs to drink more milk. He can't keep his fucking bones together out there. My God, if Kevin White...
And drafting linemen with back surgeries.
Oh, God, yeah. I mean, that was before. I mean, that was like Chris Williams. That was like back in the day. That was before the Ryan Pace. We can't put that on him.
Two bad GMs, though, in a row.
This is fucking... terrible. Oh, D'Angelo is fucking just as bad. This is fucking terrible. Bears, I mean, we're drafting these work players. Shaheen, we're drafting a division two. A division two
might even be like a division three. Like, who is this guy?
I think he was division two tight end, but my fucking God, what are you even doing
so high?
Second round.
Fourth or fifth round grade.
I mean, if you want to get him, pay the fucking fourth round Bears. There's no reason why we'd be reaching like these dick bums of Shaheen. Oh, he's got good measurables. Yeah, but he doesn't want to play the fucking pro level games.
He's playing high schoolers.
And Tariq Cohen, who looked pretty sexy the first couple weeks, but I mean, my goodness, he clearly doesn't even know the playbook enough to even get out there in the 2-minute drill, or like, out of this last week, out of the fucking timeout.
They just draft like unintelligent players.
They came out of the fucking timeout, and Cohen still didn't know where he was supposed to line up at.
They draft
last week. That fucking happened.
Very dumb. That's players.
Bad. That's fucking bad. Like, when you come out of the fucking timeout and you still don't know where you're supposed to line up at? Holy fuck, boys. That's fucking bad. That's on coaching. And I mean, yeah, Tariq Cohen, I mean, that's on you too. Well, that's a lot on coaching, because these coaches need to realize that Tariq Cohen doesn't know what the fuck he's doing, and that you need to go over there and be like, hey, bud, you need to fucking stand over here. This is where you stand. Right fucking here. You stand right there, bud. You stand right fucking here. You don't fucking do it. You don't fucking go over there. You stand right fucking here, bud. Like, this is what you need to do. I mean, they need to fucking realize that these dudes... Oh, I mean, my God. I mean, both these dudes were like Division II players. Tariq Cohen and fucking Jean taking these fucking lawn darts on these fucking guys with these high ceilings. How about we just get some high floor players, fucking Bears,
who just can contribute? Just good value guys.
Even guys like Ed Jackson. We got Ed Jackson the fourth. He's a rookie. He's been looking sexy. I mean, I'm not saying Ed Jackson is like anyway like going to turn into shit for the Bears out there, but man, did he look like shit on fucking Sunday. You see Aguilar just fucking like basically shake his ass out of his boots on that Aguilar receiving touchdown. Not the Aguilar fumble recovery touchdown. The Aguilar receiving touchdown. I mean, my God, it looks like fucking Ed Jackson was wearing fucking cement shoes out there. He just fucking like put it on. I know Aguilar is a fucking like athletic freak, but my fucking goodness, he just put his dick in the fucking dirt and just fucking made him look like a fucking little bitch. He made him look like a bitch.
I know the jury's not out, but look at big old Mitchie. Look what they gave away to get Mitchie.
Oh,
what?
Oh, my fuck. And they just keep giving these things. How much is it going to be?
You
How
look
much
at a guy who had like 13 career college starts and you trade the farm. You're not... What's your ceiling this year, Bears? Probably like 4 wins, I would say, going into the season. 4-win ceiling. You trade away that many picks to get quality starters like Jamal Adams?
Listen, the like cum stain.
They don't get him.
The cum stain on my jeans from the fucking Trubisky preseason game is fucking dried up, Bears. Shit's fucking dry, Bears. How long do we get to fucking be like, well, some part of it is the offensive line's banged up. How much is it fucking that? How much is it that a receiving core is depleted slash doesn't fucking exist? How much of it is that? How much of it is, oh, he just doesn't know how to necessarily run a pro offense because he's only played 13 fucking college fucking football starts. He's had about half as many pro starts as he's had college fucking football starts. I mean, how much is it that? But when do we get to fucking finally grade upon performance? Because the performance, besides a few shining plays like that little scramble on fourth down last week against the Lions, my God, some of these throws are just like so grossly inaccurate. I mean, what the fuck?
Well, that was the knock on him. His like short distance throws, great accuracy. Anything over 15 yards.
I mean, I'm not saying Trubisky's dog shit, but then no fucking way should we have paid the fucking Piper to move up one spot. When you're moving up one spot, you're basically trading against yourself. You're basically fucking bidding war against your fucking self. Because you're saying that somebody else behind us is like chomping at the bit to fucking make this trade. And the fucking team in front of us wants you to fucking believe that, Bears, you fucking dipshits. Because they want you to pay the fucking Piper. You under fucking stand me, Bears?
I mean, look,
my God.
I mean, like, Lynch looked like a complete genius. Trade down one spot, get the guy they wanted in the first place, and these additional picks.
John Lynch in his first year as a GM just fucking shoves his fucking dick in the Bears' ass. Fucking God sakes, Bears. I mean, you're watching the fucking Bears out there. You're watching the Bears, and you want someone to go Oprah. You want to fucking, like, control. You want to control the, you want to empower the pain, you know. You want to empower the pain. Like, I'm going through this much fucking pain watching the Bears, I might as well just punch myself right in the fucking cock so at least I'm getting control of the pain that I'm suffering. You know what I'm saying? Just go ahead and just punch myself right in the fucking cock so at least I know I'm in control of my own pain, not the Chicago fucking Bears. I'm fucking serious. Just punch myself right in the fucking cock, Bears.